بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته
Welcome to Islam and Life. Dear viewers, Islam and Life is your regular weekly program about the very aspect of every moment of our life and about the Islam. How can we learn more about Islam? Through this program. This is the main aim and objective of this program. I'm your host, Raju Ali, is here with you as regular with our honorable guest, the honorable vice principal of Jamia Islamia Birmingham, Shaykh Faizulhaq Abdulaziz. Assalamu alaikum, Shaykh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Thank you for being with us.
No problem, you're welcome.
Dear viewers, as regular, we choose a topic today. The topic we are continuing from past several weeks, the major scenes of Islam. Today we choose a very unique and very important topic of major scenes. It is one of the very severe sins is considered in terms of the Islamic belief. Not only the Islamic belief, it's also considered as a very great sins or a great disadvantage of the humanity. The great sins we consider today's topic is pride or arrogance. Pride or arrogance is considered is a very great and severe sins, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it will be severely punished. So without further delay, we should start our introductory lecture about the pride from hear it from our Shaykh. Assalamu alaikum, Shaykh, once again.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Can we start about the today's topic, the pride?
Inshallah.
We choose this topic, I think it's very important in terms of our Islamic belief.
Barakallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen wal aqibatu lil muttaqeen. والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ومن تبعهم ودعا بدعوتهم وسلك مسلكهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي ربي زدني علما respected brothers and sisters, welcome you again in our regular program, to our regular program, Islam and Life. As the brother Raju Ali has already mentioned, mashallah, we're going to discuss, as we've been doing for the past few weeks, the major sins. And the series of talks on the topic major sins we have chose it is due to the reason major sins are those things which deprive people from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which drive people away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if people are off from those sins and they return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they become the beloved servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They become the beloved friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They live in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have the comfort from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, my brothers and my sisters, today inshallah, in today's show, we'll be talking about another major sins, which is pride and arrogance. My brothers and my sisters, as far as pride and arrogance is concerned, they are the two things which drive a person away from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make him arrogant, make him or her arrogant, and then they persuade the person to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, consider themselves to be the best of everybody, consider themselves to be superior than everybody, and it creates those kind of feelings inside of not obeying any of the authority, not obeying the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, commands of his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when this person, people develop this evil thing as known as arrogance or pride inside them, even in the social life as well, they become quite arrogant. In the family life as well, they become arrogant. With the children, they become arrogant. With the wives, they become arrogant. In the society, they become arrogant. And many a times, they neglect many of the law and the order of the society is due to because of the arrogance and the pride which they have inside. Therefore, Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has in details talked about this issue, the arrogance and pride, and Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given the cure as well, how to consider yourself a humble person, a polite person, and a gentle person. As far as these are concerned, Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned them in the hadith. My brothers and my sisters, before we proceed further, let's try to understand what is actually pride. Right. How can we define pride? How can we define arrogance? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he himself has said, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ مُعَلِّمًا. I have been sent by Allah Azza wa Jalla as a teacher. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught the humanity all the things, things regarding the personality of a person, morality of a person, the social conduct of a person, how to behave in the society, how to behave in the family, how to behave as a person, etc., etc. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us everything. And many a times Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam defines things very beautifully for us. And because in the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, "Utitu jawami al-kalim." I have been granted by Allah Azza wa Jalla very precise words. Okay? So the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are very precise, that the meaning is vast. Once you open this little phrase of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, once you open this little hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you can go on and on and on explaining them. In fact, you can write a book on them. So this is the beauty Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given by Allah Azza wa Jalla. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would talk very less. But within this phrase, within this hadith, within this little speech he has made, there's lots of meaning hidden inside. You can say like hidden gems, you can dig them out from the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If I give you a few examples, then you'll understand. For example, in one hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam defined what is backbiting. Backbiting is another major sin as well, inshallah. Sometimes we'll elaborate on that as well, inshallah. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given the best possible definition of backbiting. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, "Dhikruka akhaka bima yakra." Only 3-4 words. Little sentence. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, the whole essence of backbiting is remembering your brother or sister in a way that if they were to observe or hear that from you, they will mind. You hear me? So backbiting, such a beautiful way Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has explained that remembering your brother or sister in a way that if they were to observe that from you or hear that from you, then what will happen is that they will mind. They will get upset. They won't like it. They wouldn't thought that you would make a comment regarding them like that. So that will make them upset. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has considered that to be as backbiting. In another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has defined very beautifully as well, what is sin? When a person disobeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when a person harms somebody, when a person does something evil, what is the definition of that? There are many ways you can define that, but look at the concise and the precise words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said in a very too short phrase, Al-ithmu ma haka fi sadrika wa karihta an yattali'a alayhi an-nas. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, the definition of al-ithm, the sin, is that ma haka fi sadrik. When you are about to do it, it clicks in your mind that I shouldn't be doing so. I shouldn't be saying so. But why does a person does it? Or why does a person say it? Because he likes to do it. He has a desire. He has an anxiety. He has an anger. So he wants to take the revenge from somebody. So he's doing it. He's fulfilling his desire. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-ithmu ma haka fi sadrika. The first part of the definition of sin is when a person does that, he realizes something from inside him, the soul is telling him not to do it. He has a click inside his mind and the spirit that you shouldn't be doing so. Wa karihta an yattali'a alayhi an-nas. And the second part of the sin Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions, he says, you dislike people knowing about it. Allahu Akbar. Look at such a super way Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is defined. He has said that sin is something which clicks in your mind. Your inner you tells you not to do it. Even though with the physical body you are doing it, I am doing it. But the inner you and I, the spirit tells us not to do it. And وَكَرِهْتَ أَن يَطَّلِعَ عَلَيْهِ النَّاسِ. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and you dislike people knowing about it. Now if you compare these two definitions, number one, backbiting, and number two, sin, can you think of any other better definition than these two?
No,
no way. Because Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's words are scaled. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa words are precise, concise, to the point, made so clear. Similarly, for pride and arrogance as well, in a hadith of Sahih Muslim, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the way he explains that is just to the point. Without any hesitation, somebody can understand it and go to the bottom of it. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, kibru, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, as far as the arrogant and pride is concerned, arrogance and the pride is concerned, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, al-kibru batrul haqqi wa ghamtun nasi. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, as far as pride and arrogance is concerned, is to deny the truth and humiliate the people. So in two sentences, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in a short hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has explained the definition of pride and arrogance. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, the pride is to, Allahu Akbar, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, batrul haqq, to deny the truth. When the truth is clear, when the truth has come, despite knowing this is the truth, okay, not to do it, not to accept it, not to reject it. That is known as the first part of the arrogance. And number two, humiliate the people. Always considering oneself that I am better than others. Whatever I am wearing, that's the best. Whatever I am saying, that's the best. Whatever I am wearing, that's the best. Whatever living standard I have, that's the best. Whatever car I have, that's the best. Whatever house I have, that's the best. Wherever I am living, that's the best. The skills I have, they are the best ones. All the others, they are lower than me. So Subhan al-Malik al-Quddus, my brothers and my sisters, if we consider and if we combine both of the definition, both parts of the definition, and put them together, Subhanallah, look at how beautifully Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has defined the pride.
Not only beautifully, it's very simple.
Very simple, yes. Jazakallah for mashallah fulfilling that.
And if we look at our today's world, we can find lots of example of it, mm-hmm. and we can experience through the mm-hmm. other people's. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, takabbur barai, or arrogance and pride is that, batar al-haq, to deny the truth. For example, everyone knows, those of us lovers, love our program, Islam and Life, they know that on Sky Channel 8 to 5, Islam and Life begins at 2 o'clock, England time 2 o'clock. Somebody says, no, it begins at 4 o'clock, for example, for argument's sake. All the thousands of viewers, they know this program begins 2 o'clock England time from London, 2 o'clock live. He says, no, I called it 4 o'clock, so I'll call it 4 o'clock. Now, if there is somebody like that, who despite the truth or the reality becoming visible to him, clear to him, he still denies, this is known as batar al-haq, denying the truth. If you relate that to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, or to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for example, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there. He created the whole universe. He is the provider. He is the sustainer. He does everything. With his willpower, everything is running smoothly. With his plan, everything is going through. He has sent the messengers. Out of the messengers, the last one is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was a man who performed so much of the miracles, who came with the final book of Allah azza wa jalla. Now, all these are true and they came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does exist, and all the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are there. Now, despite knowing all that, denying it, that is the part of arrogance. For example, all the audience know our presenter brother Raju Ali. If I say, no, you are not Raju Ali, you are Ma'ruf Ali, for example. Now people will say, what's wrong with this Shaykh? Everyone knows this brother known as Raju Ali. Why does he have to call him Ma'ruf Ali? Are you with me? Because everyone knows that this is your true name, not Ma'ruf Ali. That's the wrong name I'm giving. So, Batar al-Haq in a hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam very beautifully has said, when the reality is clear, it's apparent, still people don't accept that, that is known as arrogance. And then the second part of the arrogance, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that humiliating people, wa ghamtun nas, always considering myself to be the best one. Whenever people contradict with me, whenever people do have any kind of differences of the opinion with me, that's it. I cannot tolerate that. I don't want to accept their difference with me. I don't want to accept them. And I don't want to accept their different opinion with me as well. Whatever I have said, that's the full stop. Whatever I do, that's the full stop. This is the best one. So in this very beautiful short hadith, Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has explained to us, and we came to know what is the definition of pride, which is we are going to discuss today. To deny the truth when it's clear. And number two, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, humiliate the people. Now comes the question, as a Muslim, as a believer, as a mu'min, why shouldn't we have pride? Why? My brothers and my sisters, because pride is such a thing which drives a person away from the straight path. pride a thing which drives a person away from the people. Pride is such an evil thing. Once established in the heart, then this person's destiny is going to definitely be Jahannam, because pride and respect, they are the two qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As human, we are so weak. We are the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have nothing to boast about. We have nothing to be arrogant about. We have nothing to be proud about. We have nothing to have on our own. Everything is given to us by Allah azza wa jalla. So if the master has given us everything and we are just nothing but the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then in what sense we have this arrogance and pride inside us? This is why ulama, they have said, the first sin committed against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was by shaitan, which was pride. When Allah azza wa jalla ordered all the angels that prostrate to Adam alayhi salatu wasalam in order to fulfill the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all the angels in one go, وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated in Surah Al-Baqarah, in the beginning of the Holy Quran, that when we said to the angels that prostrate to Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, all the angels in one go, those angels who were at that time up there, those who were in the world, wherever the angels were, throughout the whole universe, everyone just prostrated by obeying the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they prostrated to Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. But only one he did not. Aba wastakbara, that illa iblis, except for the iblis, the shaitan, the devil, he didn't do. He did not listen to the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, neither he obeyed to the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aba, Allah azza wa jalla says in the Quran, he denied to fulfill the command of Allah, wastakbara. And look at the Arabic word Allah has used, wastakbara. If you come across any Arabic word like that, which has a alif and the sin in the beginning, that means a person doesn't have a quality inside, but he's pretending to be one of them. So Allah says, istakbara. Devil never had anything to do, any pride or arrogance, and to show anything like that to Allah Azza wa Jalla, but he pretended to be. He pretended to be that I am better than Adam. Why should I prostrate to Adam? And the vice, it should be the vice versa. Adam should prostrate to me. So therefore, ulama, they have said, the first crime committed against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it was arrogance and it was pride committed by the devil, which will lead everyone to destruction, like he has already destructed himself and he has led him towards Jahannam. So therefore, arrogance and pride, they are the things which drive a person away from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And once it goes inside and stays inside, and it makes its place in the heart, then what happens is that gradually, he and she, that person, they lose the capacity of accepting the truth or being on the truth. Because every time you'll see that person who has arrogance inside him or her, they always argue with people. They are not very willing to accept the other people's opinion. They are not those people who will always be polite and gentle and ask for forgiveness. It's like, always I am right, always I am right. Whatever I have said, that's the only thing. It's like bossing around type. You hear me? So as far as a person who has this thing inside, what will happen is that he will not harm anyone except himself. Except himself. Whatever goes around, comes around. Are you with me? So if I am, for example, boasting with other people, are you with me? Then the consequences of this boasting will come to me, and it will harm me. It will harm my health. It will harm my character. It will harm my reputation, etc., etc. It will destroy only me, not anyone else. Allahu Akbar. In the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam has very beautifully he has explained. The hadith is narrated by Imam Muslim rahmatullahi alayhi. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, لَا يَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ أَحَدٌ فِي قَلْبِهِ مِثْقَالُ ذَرَّةٍ مِّنْ كِبْرٍ. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, that person will not enter paradise who has in his heart the smallest amount of arrogance in his heart. The Arabic word Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has used is the word zarra. And the amazing thing, Prophet ﷺ is using this word dharra. Dharra literally means when you make a pinch like that with the tip of your thumb and the tip of your index finger, and pick anything from the ground. Okay? Once you pick that from the ground, the thing which is between your thumb and the index finger tip, okay, tips, okay? If you were to break that into 100 pieces, and one of those pieces is known as dharra in Arabic. In English, we can call it the smallest size of the atom. The smallest thing which you can imagine. We need a superpower magnifying glass to see that. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that if a person has a smallest amount of the smallest atom of the arrogance or the pride inside his heart, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, this person will not enter paradise. Why? Because as far as pride and arrogance is concerned, they belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are the qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only being who has the capacity and the power to have pride and arrogance. Why? Because He controls everything. He provides everyone. He does give everybody everything, every need fulfilled by Allah Azza wa Jalla. Therefore, if that is the case, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the pride and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the arrogance. This is why in the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam quotes from Allah Azza wa Jalla that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, Al-kibriya'u rida'i. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said that, Allah Azza wa Jalla has said, Al-azmatu izari. Wal-kibriya'u rida'i. فَمَنْ نَازَعَنِي فِيهِمَا أَلْقَيْتُهُ فِي النَّارِ. Again in the hadith of Sahih Muslim, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam quotes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah azza wa jalla has said, Al-azmatu izari. The dignity and respect is the lower portion of my clothes. وَالْكِبْرِيَاءُ رِدَائِ. And the arrogance and pride is the higher portion of my clothes. When we normally wear clothes, we have two pieces. Okay? In the olden days, people used to wear the lower portion, which sometimes you can call as lungi, and the upper portion, which is known as shroud, which is known as a shawl or a chadar, for example. Together, they become the dress of a person. Nowadays, you can call a shirt or a trouser. Okay, together becomes the full length covering of the body. Okay, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, as far as the al-azma and al-kibriya, the dignity and respect and the might and the arrogance and the pride is concerned, totally belongs to me. Like a person, by wearing the lower portion of the clothes and the higher portion of the clothes, a person is fully covered. A person is fully covered. From top to bottom, he is fully covered. Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, as far as the pride and arrogance, might and respect and dignity are concerned, they fully belong to me. No one else. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, فَمَنْ نَازَعَنِي فِيهِمَا أَلْقَيْتُهُ فِي النَّارِ. Whoever tries to snatch this from me, I will put him into the hellfire. I will put him into the hellfire. Now comes the question, why is that Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying somebody tries to be arrogant, Allah will put him into hellfire. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying somebody has the smallest atom of arrogance in his heart or her heart, they will not go to the Jannah. Why is that? Why Allah and Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are both kind of strict regarding this quality to have in the heart? Why is that? The answer is that, my brothers and my sisters, Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are really merciful with the servants. They're really merciful with the followers. They know those things which will deprive a person from the mercy of Allah, take a person away from the mercy of Allah, drive a person away from the Jannah, which is the ultimate destination for everybody. So Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam strictly telling us, stay away from it. Don't adopt that. Because ultimately, once you have adopted that, what will happen is that you will proceed towards Jahannam, which is not your destination. But because you have adopted some evil qualities, that will ultimately will take you to the evil. For example, somebody wants to go from London to Birmingham or Manchester. Rather than taking M1 North or M40 North, he's taking some other drive and motorways, which is taking him towards Bournemouth or Portsmouth. Now, this person, more he continues driving, he will be going towards France and then towards Europe. He will never be able to go towards Birmingham or Manchester because that's towards the north. So a person who has been created by Allah Azza wa Jalla to go to Jannah, to go to paradise, by adopting this kind of evil characteristics inside him, this person will leave the path of Jannah and he will continue to the path of Jahannam. Therefore, Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they very strictly, they inform the people that this is the ultimate result is going to be. If you have adopted that, then you will not be able to go to paradise. In fact, you will be going to Jahannam, which is a destructive place to go to, which is a very evil place to go to, not a very smooth and nice place to go to. Therefore, in Sharia, kibir, arrogance and pride is considered as one of the major sins, those sins, grave sins, which lead the people towards destruction, which leads the people towards Jahannam, and finally and ultimately make a person rebellious against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, disobedient against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and a person who does not listen to the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, does not fulfill the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the reason we have started this series of talk, because the main purpose of our program is to promote the da'wah of Islam to people and support them. them how to practice it.
JazakAllah Shaykh, thank you very much. It's time for a short break. Allow us to go through. Dear viewers, we are listening very wonderful lectures about the pride and arrogance. We'll continue about that after a short break. Please bear with us. Till then, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.